Today, we shall discuss on editorial writing. The editorial of a newspaper is the soul of the newspaper. The editorial reflects the policy and stand of the newspaper on the burning issues of the day. Strong and powerful editorials published in popular newspapers mold public opinion and acts as a catalyst of change. They also serve as the watchdog of public interest by pointing out anomalies and irregularities in public policies and developmental works, besides offering suggestions and solutions to problems and burning issues of the society. Editorial writing has always been an art which has to be mastered by practice and judicious use of language. It cannot be written in the style of a news report, nor in the format of an article. Limitation of words and space offer the editorial writer a challenge to encapsulate his thoughts and views within the given framework by using the appropriate word uses and language to tackle his subject. A good editorial is one that is not only thought-provoking but also eminently readable. All editorials in the newspaper are published in the name of the editor. However, all editorials are not written by the editor himself. In a big or medium-sized newspaper, there is generally a panel of editorial writers who are assigned subjects of their specialized study by the editor. You see, the general impression of the common readers is that the editor writes the editorials. There was a day when he used to do that, when the sizes of the newspapers were small and the world was a much peaceful place than what it is today, when developments were not as drastic as it is today. So then the pace of development was very slow. Then the editor could write his editorial, his daily editorial every day. But today, with so many problems and issues cropping up, it is not humanly possible. So, and also the editor might not be a specialist in many subjects. So he has to take the help of his panel writers who are specialized in that area of study. So that is why a panel of editorial writers today work in tandem with the editor. Of course, it must be remembered that in dealing with issues which are of a delicate nature and which needs the attention of the editor to point out or to spell out the newspaper's policy or stand on certain burning issue of the day, the editor takes up the pen to write the editorial, because on that he does not want to, he would not like to depend on his panel writers, because their thinking might not be different from what the paper stand might be. So this is very important. While we're discussing the editorial content, we have to remember that in the days when the communication technology was in its nascent stage and the geopolitical situation in the world was developing at a very slow pace, the general trend for the newspapers was to have one or at the most two editorials. As the electronic media like the television was not much developed, the people depended on the newspaper for the news and views on the developments taking place around the world. As most of the readers were not aware of the background in which the situation was taking place in the earlier days, so the trend of editorial writing in the older days was to first explain the background of the situation. So generally the first paragraph used to be devoted in explaining the ground situation, the background. So that why it was happening, what is the causes and all that. That used to be the beginning, the trend, like the style of writing. Then the editorial used to go and discuss the consequences and other possibilities of the developing situation. And the editorial used to be concluded by offering the suggestions or solutions to the problem that the editorial was handling. However, with the development of communication technology, the world today has become very much closer. Any happening around the globe is immediately flashed on the television screens. People are today aware of the developments taking place by watching the events on the television. So they already know what is happening all over the world. As such, the reader of the newspaper need not be explained what was the background of the event, that is what is happening and all. Present day editorials, that is why, directly approach the subject with the newspaper's views and comments, thereby cutting down the number of words, views and compared to other editorials. That is, thereby cutting down the number of words compared to the earlier editorials. This has given the editorial writers liberty to write two or three editorials regularly, touching on various subjects. Now, you see, as we have cut down on the background situation, so this has given the editorial writer space to write one or two editorials more. That is why in today's newspapers you see about at least three editorials coming in most of the, say, national dailies and all. Even some of our local dailies, we are having two editorials. So the number of editorials are increasing. And this is due to this factor, that we are cutting down on the backgrounders. We don't have to explain to the reader what has happened, because they are already aware of what is happening by watching the television news and other, internet and all. So that is why now, while increasing the number of editorials, most newspapers have today introduced an offbeat editorial on some, giving some humorous subjects and all. So they are adding a third editorial, which is lessening the burden of the serious subjects. If you write two editorials on very serious issue, the third editorial might be of a, let's say, on a lighter subject, with a bit of witty remarks, comments or humor, to lessen the burden of the reader of the serious issues.